Are you Meredith Grey?
Yeah.
I'm Lexi.
Great, move!
Lexi Grey, I'm your sister.
Like a virgin.
Hey!
Touched for the very first time. Like a
I can draw really, really well on an Etch-a-Sketch. Like, really well. Like, I could be a professional if, you know, that profession existed.
I told her I could draw with an Etch-a-Sketch. Of all the things I could have chosen, no wonder she thinks I'm pathetic.
Photographic memory, huh?
Yeah.
Periodic table. Go.
Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, sodium, magnesium, aluminum, silicone, phosphorus, sulfur. I can keep going.
Sit the flowers.
Hi. Are you asking as a resident or a sister?
Sister.
I'm stealing stuff.
Okay.
He forgot he had sex with me.
I just collected the
flowers. He forgot he had sex with me? And Alex, he wrote this essay to get in, this moving, beautiful essay about how his grades weren't that good during med school because he was suffering from testicular cancer.
What?
He said he lost a ball. But I've seen him make it. He has 2 mandarins, George, 2 pouch potatoes.
He's the emergency, himself. It's on his person.
Wait, Mark's hurt?
Yes. No, yes. He's badly injured, in a bad way that it's bad for anyone who's a man. But for Dr. Sloan in particular, he may have broken a bone.
A bone.
He broke a bone. I broke his bone. Oh, French fries. God, I love French fries.
If not for the patient, for me. Or for Lexi. Look at her. Face is breaking out. Her ass is humongous.
It's true. I had to get the scrubs with the elastic waistband.
Gosh, my ass really...
Lexi.
Should I be offended? Because I've been trying to come up with a good reason why you paged every resident to the skills lab but me. Me. Your sister. Your sister, Derek.
You're on my service.
You're dehydrated and you're stressed. You really should drink something.
I said I'm fine.
Drink the water. I said drink it! Alex and I, we've done it before. I was recycling. It was, like, good for the environment.
Izzy's gone. I was horny. She was there.
Oh, crap. I am a dirty mistress. Oh, God, you're going to tell Derek, and then Derek's going to tell Mark that I'm a whore.
Calm down, please.
Oh, no, I am calm. I am so calm. I'm, like, the calmest one.
Perjury.
Me, I am the calmest one! No!
And then, look, don't tell me Lexi's not worried.
Is he in here?
No, Lexi's worried.
And now I find myself relating to the crazy jealous lady who drives into laundromats. They're in there.
No, you should knock first.
I'm late. Okay, my hair is dirty, and he just gave her $80 for a muffin and a sandwich.
That's quite a sandwich.
She's just gonna end up spending it on a pair of jeans that show off her butt crack, and then she's gonna ask me for half of my pasta salad.
You sound like my mother.
I will wear a diaper. My diaper is awesome. My diaper is hardcore. You wish you had the balls to wear my diaper. I'm gonna wear it, and I'm gonna wear it with pride. And if I have to pee in it, oh, I'll pee. Because I am a surgeon. This is America, and I will do what needs to be done. So you can kiss my hardcore diaper-wearing ass. Are you really gay? Like, how gay are you? On a scale of 1 to gay. Because that's my boyfriend in the shower. My hot, hot, naked boyfriend. And how gay are you?
My God.
Oh! Ouch. Ugh. Is this a sex injury?
Oh, my God.
It is. Oh. I used to have sex injuries with Mark. Mark was really awesome at leaving you with good sex injuries.
Please don't cry on my ass.
I'm sorry.
Please don't cry.
Yeah, she's up here. She's wiped it a couple times. Oh, you all sound really old. My heart does not live in my vagina.
After the news, I just had to call.
The news?
Well, we're gonna have a baby. I'm pregnant.
How?
I mean, wow, congratulations. That's joyous news.
I think I'd go with psych.
That was a joke.
That was good.
Anyway, it starts with a giant butt, and then the next thing you know, she's giving up her friend, she's moving in with him before she's even ready, and if she's not careful, she'll find herself a 26-year-old stepmother to the pregnant daughter she didn't even know he had. And then she's single, dyeing her hair a new color, and you know what? It's really hard to manage your roots and you've been committed to the psych ward.
Psych ward.
It happens.
Well, what about you? Hitting the town?
I'm not hitting much of anything these days.
No arm. This is your relief pitcher? Hey, my grandma's not busy. She can pitch better than that.
Oh, right in the booth. What? I thought she was stealing second. Julia. Of course. No, I'm going to tell him because if you don't say anything, then you bleed out and die and read about it in a plastic locket. I mean, what do you think?
What should I do?
Zola?
Well, tell me.
Hey, guess what? I'm on Pete's today. Babies. Yay. Mark, wait. You should check out the latest Nine Inch Nails album. It is pretty fresh.
Okay.
I said fresh. Teach me.
What are you doing? Don't do that. Stop.
Teach me.
Stop.
Teach me.
We can't do this. You're a little gray, and I promised, and I'm your teacher.
So, teach me.
Oh, Lexi.
Teach me. Teach me. Come on, am I really so bad?
You okay?
I love you. Oh, God, oh my God, that just came flying out of my face. Like it was just some kind of, I love you. I just, God, did it again. I love you. I do. I love you. And I have been trying not to say it. I have been trying so hard to just mash it down and ignore it and not say it. And you're in me. It's like you're a disease. It's like I am infected by Mark Sloan. And I can't think about anything or anybody. And I can't sleep. I can't breathe. I can't eat. And I love you. I love you all the time. It's every minute of every day. And I love you.
Because we're supposed to end up together. We're meant to be.
Meant to be. I don't want to be here. I'd give anything to not be here. No, to have my life work out the way I planned, and to even have time to ask what about me. So you change, you get over it. I'm here now. So if the having of a life and a body isn't cause for celebration, then what's the point of avoiding death?